Hello, it's me with no hat. But it doesn't matter because you can't see the top of my head, right? And you can only see this neck. So you don't know what I'm playing, do you? Yeah, I do. Playing a wolf gang. A real one, EVH, I know. And yeah, so they got some spots on it. They're coming off. So and zip. I haven't tuned this thing since the last time I played it, which is like 2 months ago or a month. And I'm back up here. I gotta make the CD covers first, sorry. So it's not ready unless you just want a copy. And then I'll send you the CD cover later. But that's it. Trick or treat. Some people are asking, dude, do you think Randy actually played? No, dude, that is Tony and, or Carlos and Tony Cavazo. Carlos Cavazo on guitar, Tony Cavazo on bass. Basically, this band Snow took the two brothers, threw them in with Dubrow, the band Dubrow. They put in Dingleberry, Frank Vanelli on drums, and they played every friggin' weekend. Or weekday at the Troubadour. it seem like we're going to see Dubrow. And there'd be like 5 people there, 10 people there, 3 people there. But we went to see it because me and my friend really liked Snow. And they sounded a lot like Snow, which is like a little ripoff of Van Halen. You know, Carlos was good. He was a great guitar player. He was right there. Like, everybody talks about how, you know, George Lynch. George Lynch hasn't done nothing. I mean, he's good. He's way better than me. But to me, he's no big thing. And the reason he didn't get the Ozzy gig, and I don't care what anybody says, is because when he walked in, he looked like a 12-year-old boy. That's exactly what they said. That's where I got that from. Even when I sat down to take lessons with him, I'm like, how old is this guy? Because he looks old, but he's got the haircut of a 12-year-old. And it's because he worked a job so he could afford to buy, you know, good equipment and stuff. And for Randy, his job was teaching, and he would just take the equipment that Musonia had and use it. It wasn't a guitar amp, that's for dang sure, you could sure tell. But he used so many, you know, effects that he got that sound. The sound that he got. And then when it went through Marshalls, it was bigger, and then of course he, you know, double, triple track and everything. So, I always get into Randy stuff, don't I? I don't know, because people like to hear it. mom. I gotta go. So that's it for tonight. Celebration of life. Don't call it anything else. And you know how you're not supposed to have 10 people. We had 60 people jammed in the backyard. And then we did it on Zoom. So there was like several hundred people watching it on Zoom. But some people for some reason thought they couldn't pick it up unless they were parked right in front of that. So there's people parked all up and down the street watching it in their car on Zoom. When they could have just come back, they already had 60-something people in the backyard, which was way over the limit that we're supposed to have. But some people had masks on. I didn't, because I think it's all a bunch of bullcrap. I think it's a political hack, and it's not any worse than the flu. And I already got that. Done with that. Got that in March, and test support and everything, and had to make sure I was healthy because mom, who passed away on the 8th of this month, so 8th of June, basically 7 a.m. And that was it, I was right there, and not something you really ever want to do again, and I don't have to. And so what freaks me out is I was like 15% chance of pulling out of my coma. Back in 2009, when I was in the wreck, they thought I was going to die. I had died already several times, and you know, I already told you the story. And she's like, you know, you can't die. You know, you're not supposed to see you're not supposed to bury your children. I'm like, okay, great, but you can't go until you're like 100. She goes, okay, 190 something, because all her parents, 96 and like 100. 107 months her dad lived, and he was a, and the mom was just, you know, my grandma, that one, she was like 96, and she just, you know, existed, and then, I didn't even go to the funeral, either of them, and it did nothing. She didn't hardly, like, mom, you sad, you want to talk, you want to die. So her parents must have been gems. I heard they were really bad. very bad parents. And a lot went on and whatever, and she, so that's why she is determined to be the best mom that she could be. And I don't care what anybody says, she was the best mom ever. And she made my childhood perfect. And it was perfect until I messed it up. You know, 17, 18, when I started getting crazy. But, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. You gotta go through life and live and learn and hopefully learn and not repeat the mistakes that, you know, some people I see repeating over and over. They're in their 50s and they're still drinking and taking drugs and screwing their lives straight to crap. Not that I'm, you know, doing incredible, but I was doing incredible until that accident. Now I'm just kind of trying to figure out a way to, well, you know, I got my things lined up, and I don't think I'll be living in California much longer. I'm looking to get out of here. Permanent. Because, see, the whole thing was my son moved to Utah. And I'd been going to Utah back and forth forever, for like the past 20 years. So he moves up.